That's the Bank of Ireland Men's Players Player of the Year Award. To be selected by your peers as the best of the best is truly a great honour. And there are some very deserving nominees for this award this year. But this man stood shoulder and head guard above the rest. He's a Wicklow boy at heart, but over the last 12 months, in particular, he's made the RDS and the Aviva and practically every bloody pitch he's played on his home in the Leinster and Ireland jerseys, with breathtaking displays of aggression, tackling, speed, and an eye for a try or two. The 2022 Bank of Ireland Men's Players Player of the Year is Josh Van der Fleer. Congratulations. I've never been in your house or your apartment, I have to say, to be fair. That trophy cabinet, the Rugby Players of Ireland thing, European Player of the Year, an award like this, that's a big mountain piece, is it?
I would say that. I'm going to keep them hidden away. It's been an enjoyable season, but yeah, I keep them hidden away, to answer your question.
You do? Oh, right. Okay. That's not the answer I was expecting. Come here. It's just been a fantastic period of time for you again, like talking to Michelle, for the players that you play alongside. Not that you're ticking off things in your head when you're playing a match. Oh, I'll give him one vote. I won't bother voting for him. To be selected by your peers must be an incredible feeling.
Yeah, it's an incredible honour. Those lads are the people I look up to, some of them my heroes when I was going through school. And they're the lads you want to please, the lads you want to play for, the lads you want to win for. So for them to think of me in that way and hold me to that esteem is incredibly humbling. Delighted with that, but I suppose it's for me it's more trying to contribute as much as I can to the team, and it's obviously very pleasing to get this award, but be most pleased now with the win and this weekend coming and the week after, so it's probably my priority.
And when you see, the lads standing on the stage, the people who are leaving, you look at the likes of Sean, Devon, Dan Levy, people like that, does it drive it home to you how fortunate you are to have a career? You're still playing rugby at the top level.
For sure, yeah. I think Dan in particular, him announcing his retirement to us a couple of months ago hit me pretty hard, because I guess we would have competed with each other all the way along, and I guess I'm still playing. I'm up here because I got a bit lucky, or he got unlucky, or so that was pretty tough, and I guess that's the game, that's the way it goes. I suppose we'll all have to finish up at some stage, but I'm incredibly proud and delighted and honoured to have shared the field with those kind of lads and all the lads who are up here leaving. A lot of great, great friends and people I'll be able to look forward to a catch up with soon as well.
You've made friends for life, haven't you?
For sure, yeah, for sure. I think this group especially, winning games together, hopefully this season winning a trophy together, those are the things that bond you together more than anything else, really. And beyond that, aside from the rugby, there's a lot of great, great people, really great people who I can call my best friends as well. So, yes, very special group.
Do you include Sophie in that?
Pardon?
Do you include Sophie in that as some great people and people
I do,
here?
Of course, yeah. My fiance, yeah, we got engaged this year, so it's exciting. I'm a very lucky man, so it's been a good year.
How's the planning going?
All good. Yeah, getting through it. Well, sorry, I'm doing nothing. She's doing everything.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah. That's what I thought, to be fair. That's why I asked the question. There's a big couple of weeks coming up. United Rugby Championships, as I said, semi-final this week, potentially final the week after. I mean, there's a hell of a lot to play for, isn't there?
There is, for sure. It was a pleasing win today. It was obviously disappointing last week, but we've put that behind us. And I feel like watching the lads coming up here saying their farewells, we owe it to them as well to give it our best as well. So hopefully we can finish off on a high.
Now, as you said, there's been some incredible highs, lows, nerve-wracking moments all the way through your career, all the way through the season. Honestly, can you tell me, was the most nerve-wracking moment of your career this year when Leeds were playing Brentford on the last day of the season and they had to win to stay up?
It was definitely up there. You were telling me you couldn't watch it. So I couldn't. I was close enough. Very, very stressful. But yeah, managed to stay up. So that's good. We'll get to a game next year.
Marching on together.
Leeds.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, Josh Rondafleer. Come on, hold on, brother.